my life. I'm putting this song for it's special for you guys. Yeah, so that's it. It's a romantic song. I hear you. This song is for you guys. So I'm waiting for others to join. I was like the song today, so I was like, I'm going to turn it down soon. I want others to join. So for me, I'll do first on my life. Let me see this, if I can add you in life again. See, I can't still see you. Try it again. It's not going through. Hi, love Berry. Thanks for joining. So today's topic is mental health and its connection with suicide. I'm waiting for some people to join us. Before I proceed, good afternoon. For those in US, good afternoon or good evening. For those in Nigeria, good evening. It's 9 p.m. In Qatar, it's 11 p.m. So good evening. For those in Texas, I think it's 3 p.m. So, good afternoon. I think I have some people from UK as well. It's the evening as well. So, good evening. Thanks for joining. Maria Manga, thanks for joining. Miriam Manga, thanks for joining as well. So, today's topic is... Let me try to reduce this. Today's topic is mental health and its connection with suicide. We're talking about different topics every week. So I'm going to apologize again. I was supposed to come on live yesterday. But you know, live, so I couldn't. I'm sorry, I apologize. So first of all, I want us to really understand what mental health is. And it has to do with an individual's condition, his connection with, you know, psychological and mental well-being. That's what mental health is about. And why I'm connecting to suicide is because we all know that when one has mental illness, or maybe they show signs like, "Hi Kune, thanks for joining. And we know that once certain individuals develop symptoms of mental illness, we just know that the end point for some would be to go and commit suicide. And we keep wondering, asking ourselves, the loved ones who they live here, keep asking themselves, like, okay, what really happened? Why did this person commit suicide? Why couldn't this person talk to me? What exactly really happened? And it's a confused situation because you can't really, you know, you can't really pinpoint on why they committed suicide. You feel this person has the money, has everything going for himself or herself, and ended up committing suicide, and you're like, what really happened? So that's why we're kind of discussing on mental health and suicide. I'm not here to lecture anyone, obviously. So that's why it's Instagram live. I want everybody to drop their comments. So I'm going to go through my survey. I put out a survey earlier today. I didn't have time to do during the Monday and Tuesday, I'm so sorry guys. But some people really answer the questions, and I want to start to talk about those questions. But before then, we are setting these misconceptions that mental illness is mental weakness. we have people say that, oh, I can't be people with, can't be around people that has mood swings. I can't be around people who are always depressed. And so they stay away from such person. Fixers Network, thanks for joining. And so they stay away from such person. And we don't know how to make the situation worse for that particular individual. When it comes to mental illness, it's not that we're saying the person has gone crazy. Because sometimes, they're in Africa, we sweep this issue under the carpet and believe that, oh, there's nothing called mental illness. Even in churches, they don't discuss about what mental illness is. And they feel you're not meant to be depressed, that you're going through situations, you should be able to handle it, you're a Christian, you have the word of God, all of that. But the truth of the matter is, it's just beyond the physical. It's beyond, you know, reading the Bible to make you feel better. There's some mental illness that are actually treatable but not curable. I think for example should be schizophrenia. It's treatable but not curable. Some it's generational. But I'm not going deep into all those kind of mental illness. What I'm actually talking about now is situations where people are depressed and then they commit suicide. What do you think? So now, before asking such questions, let me just go through the survey I actually uploaded earlier today on Instagram. So, question was, do you think that mental health is overlooked in Africa? If you think so, please drop your comments or send me a request. I'm going to call you back. What's your opinion? So funny enough, 48 people believe this question. So I'm wondering why nobody, like people answered and nobody, people are not like commenting right now. So if you feel it's overlooked in Africa, why do you think so? Give your reasons. Send a request and I'll call you back so we'll talk about it. Another question I asked was, would you agree that depression, substance abuse, television and video violence, as well as easy access to firearms are risk factors that lead to suicide? Obviously, yes, a lot of risk factors. Aside this one I mentioned, depression, all of that, there are a lot of risk factors. There are reasons, there are things that put people at risk to committing suicide. On Instagram, I read a lot of stories. I read of a particular story where a man was being accused falsely at his job. And then he was released from his job. And at that moment, you know, definitely going to affect his finance. So as a result, his girlfriend or maybe his then fiancé broke up with him and said she can't be with a broke guy and all of that. So because of that, this guy committed suicide. He committed suicide, like it was so sad. End of the day, they found out that person actually lied and that he didn't commit whatever, I mean, it was fraud or something. And he committed suicide, does end his life like that. That's because he could not take the pressure of rejection. I don't know if you understand what I'm trying to say. Some people, there are things that leads to, you know, one deciding to take his or her own life. That is naturally not the way out. And that's what we have to preach out there. That the message we have to pass out there is there is more to life. And that the fact that you feel you are rejected today doesn't mean that you are going to be rejected forever. So it's important that we understand that depression is something that can be discussed, can be talked about. The fact that maybe you are depressed doesn't mean you are weak. Because some people feel that you are weak. Some people will not want to even date someone who is depressed, which is actually wrong. Hi, Teslin. Thanks for joining. I'm sorry. So the topic, I feel the topic there, which has to do with mental health and its connection with suicide. So Bumi said, people in Nigeria don't really take depression serious. They feel you just pray it away. And that's true. in Africa, we have to understand that it's not everything that prayer will solve. I think that's our problem with Africans. We feel everything is by miracles, everything is with prayers and all of that. That is not true. Some people will see cockroaches and they follow me now to US, they follow me now to London, they follow me now to UK, they follow me now to Scotland. Oh, my enemies, they are pursuing me, and then they start praying. Meanwhile, we don't understand the fact that sometimes all it takes is just brain work. All it takes is just, you know, thinking deep and looking for a solution to a problem, not just by praying. And you can't pray away depression, that's the truth. What that particular individual needs is love, care, support, you know. Not listen to the person. Don't judge the person and say, oh, you are weak because maybe you are depressed. No, you can't say the person is weak. Everyone, how do I put it now? Everybody have a way of, you know, dealing with a particular situation. You might deal with your situation differently. It's just like success. Everybody has different roads to success. You can't say, but the paramount thing there is hard work. But there are different ways. So some people woke up one morning, met their father's, they took over their father's company. Some people woke up in the morning and they had to just, they woke up with poverty and had to just thrive in life. But then she's successful. Some people became successful through automobile business. Some became successful through importing and exporting. Some is through fashion and all of that. And that's how some is through acting, and that's how they make their money. There are different ways of success. And that's the same way I would say there are different ways to healing, or different ways to deal with situation or dealing with depression. Some people really need to see a psychologist, and that is true. I think that's what we lack in Africa. We don't really have like professionals or psychologists. I don't think they will even get jobs safe if they are even psychologists. I don't think they will actually get jobs if they are actually psychologists. As I said, people don't take it serious because many people do crazy things for attention. Okay, what do you mean? But I think I can, I think I understand a little. There are times I would go on different pages on Instagram, and then there will be a particular comment. Person will say, I'm depressed, I am this, that, I'm going through this, I'm going through that. Some people will share that. Some people will say, oh, shut up. They're trying to look for attention. But what if the person is looking for attention? What if the person is really going through a particular situation? What if the person is really depressed and needs no help? So for me, I feel the best things for you to not check up on that friend. That person you feel is strong might not really be strong. It means that I look sad. That the thing that is that this depression thing, it doesn't happen in one day. It starts with mood swings, and then it grows and grows and becomes like worse. And then the next thing, the person commits suicide. Honestly, I think you should explain to us what you meant by people don't take it serious because many people do crazy things for attention. I'm trying to. Another question I asked was, do you think it's easy to open up to anyone about being depressed? Do you think it's easy for one to open up about his mental state? I think that's just it. Most people don't know how to. Most people don't like opening up, but they think maybe they're obviously maybe they think maybe they are crazy, or they think maybe they are, you know. Drop your comments, guys. I don't want to be the one to just, you know.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Okay, I'm going to pick my call first. I'm suspecting you won't pick this call for taking you. Taking time for you to speak up.
Okay. And I see some of the survey questions I put out. Not very sad.
So what was the question?
Everyone with all the I put up the question. If someone should, I put on my survey, and the question was, everyone would all be better off without me. How would you react? If someone tells you, everyone would be better off without me, no one needs me, how would you react to the person? You know, I've had discussion with some people and tell them, you know, if I'm depressed, and I said, well, depressed, and you want to end your life, but you want, like, you're depressed, are you the only one in a social situation, why do you want to kill yourself? Kill yourself now. I mean, that's how incenses are good, would be. Okay, Tessina has worked on the understand. Okay. Bumi said, I read some comments on social media and I get sad. Someone is saying they want to die and people will say they should kill themselves. And that is true. It's just so sad. And I'm telling you, if you don't have that shock absorber, you don't have that strength, you know, to withstand negative comments, you might end up committing suicide. I'm telling you, or maybe you are going through, you know, certain situations. I would not say my life has always been perfect. There are times I feel like, sometimes I feel down, sometimes I feel like, you know, I'm not there yet. I wish I was doing this at this time. Oh, at my age, I'm not this. At my age, I'm not achieved this. I'm not achieved that. And then I get, I feel down. And I tell you, that's where it starts. Especially when you have no one to talk to, when everyone is going about their lives. I know, you might feel, sometimes I feel that people are committing suicide, people are depressed, actually selfish. But it's not so. It's not so. Some people don't know. Some people just need love. Some people just need that attention. Some people need to talk to them. So it's only sad where a person husband will commit suicide. The wife is not aware of why her husband committed suicide. I mean, it sounds silly that even if the person drops a suicide note, you still can't fathom why that person would take this for her own life. But let me tell you, mental illness is real. Suicide is real. It's going on every day. People commit suicide. People see it as a way of escape to just commit suicide. But I don't feel that should be the solution. And that's why we have to talk about it. Most people talk about suicide. Most people talk about mental illness. It does feel you should have that strength to handle anything you're going through. Okay, so I made some research myself, and there are signs to mental illness. I'm sorry, I'm kind of dehydrated. That's why I'm feeling this way. So, some of the signs are feeling down or sad, confused thinking, or reduced ability to concentrate, worry, fear, mood change. Those are signs that one is mentally ill. Now, take notes. Mentally ill doesn't mean you are crazy. It doesn't mean you are weak. It doesn't mean you are violent. It's not like saying you have headache. It's something that can, you know, if you work on it at that moment, if maybe you take a personal drug at that moment, like Panadol or some sort of paracetamol, take a personal medication, it's going to get rid of that thing. That's how mental illness is. Although it's deeper than that, but it starts from somewhere. Once you can deal with it at that particular moment, once you can speak to someone, or speak to a psychologist, speak to a family friend, a pastor, or whoever you trust, once you can speak to that person, at that moment, it's at least half solved. I don't know if that's what I'm trying to say. You are feeling down, you are feeling sad. I'm telling you, people go through a lot. Sometimes you feel you're going through a lot, you hear someone's story. You're like, I give it to you, like, you're strong, you're a strong person. So yeah, so let me see what I can call again. Obviously, I can't call anyone because some of you are not popping up on my request field or something. Yeah. So I'm still waiting for you guys to drop your comments. Thank you, drop your comments. Okay, but I remember when I was in school and my results weren't how I wanted it. I was under so much pressure and I felt I wasn't good enough. Suicidal thoughts came into my mind. Yeah, it can even be as little as that. So I feel that, the outcome, some people can't handle that kind of feeling. You know, when you put a lot into something and you're not achieving that particular thing, you feel like that was the essence. I would like to also add those kind of suicidal thoughts as well. Sometimes I'm like, it's just gonna take this I'm just gonna take pills now. Like, let me just drink it. Like, I'm telling you. But I thought to myself that, okay, if I decide to end my life today, like, what would I gain? I thought to myself, what would I gain? Like, would it change anything? People will still move on with their lives. So why not just stay, try to fight, try to shed off the feelings, try to work on whatever is making me feel depressed. Aside from the fact that some people inherit this mental illness, there are still some that are being caused by, you know, the external environment. Like maybe your job was laid off, or maybe finance, maybe someone cheated a particular person. That can actually, you know, result to one being depressed and then decides to commit suicide. But there's hope. There's always hope. If one person will reject you today, tomorrow you will be someone's cornerstone. You know, the rejected will become the cornerstone. Yeah. So, yeah, that's important. So, guys, I noticed something. If I'm talking about relationship, people will be all over, like, you want to contribute. But today is about mental health, and no one is saying anything. So, what's happening? I think I should talk, man. Talk. Okay, let me play some music till everyone is ready. But see, I know to me you want to talk, but I don't know why I can't see you. I can't see you. So then I'm still with you. I'm just trying to inform people of my Instagram life. I guess it's quite busy. So guys, contribute, drop your comments. Drop your comments. So, yeah, I'll send notifications to others so they should come and join us. I'm waiting, guys. We can all just keep going. Okay. So let me continue by saying that, but I kept praying and casting those thoughts out of my mind. I'm not saying prayer doesn't work. Prayer works, but it's not just prayer. It's about care, love, opening up, speaking to someone. You might be able to speak to someone, but there should be that person you trust. I don't know if anybody has watched on Netflix. Okay, guys. One second, I'm not interested. I'm just going to. I'm back. Yes. So. Yeah, so it's really. I'll say, yeah, testing reasons why. You don't watch that movie on Netflix. It was in different seasons, but it. It's really touched me. I was watching last year. It was about a girl. People thought the girl was great. If you watch that movie, it's something that you can't really understand until you put yourself in the shoes of someone who is depressed. It was not like people took advantage of her, but they didn't know they were taking advantage of her and, like, intentionally. Don't watch this, guys. It's just something new to watch. 13 Reasons Why. Hey, Temi Tope. Hi, girl. How are you doing? How is everything? I miss you. So, call me or drop your comments. So, the topic is mental health and its connection with suicide. People are booming, drop a comment, definitely drop those comments. And I'm really talking about, you know, mental illness, its manifestations, so as well, you know, like their signs, depression, you know, mood swings and all of that. And there are a lot of misconceptions that anyone who has mental illness is crazy, or they feel the person is mentally weak or the person is violent, which is not so. I just think there are different things. the difference between mental health and mental illness and mental mental health and mental weakness or something. I want to say something. I'm really close to photos. But thing is, in Africa, not just in Africa, all over though, but I think it's majorly in Africa, we overlook mental illness. We feel everything's about praying and casting out, you know, pressure, praying and casting out that sad feeling, but that's not so. Sometimes we have to talk to someone, we have to open up, we have to be there for that person who's depressed. It's not, some people is about material things, but it's not about material things, because even those who are rich commit suicide. And you're wondering, how, why? The one that is even bad is the one that is very, very terrible is the one where that person commits suicide and wants to drag people into his death. For example, suicide bombers, people who just kill people randomly and then kill themselves. Or yeah, people who would maybe poison their girlfriend and poison themselves, or poison their boyfriend and poison themselves. They're asking, like, what's wrong with this person? Person, okay. The person was at personal points before it got to that peak. So something would have led to some trigger something. So sometimes it's always like, it's not like it's external environment that triggers that feeling within, the feeling of depression. And then it manifests into maybe committing suicide or. A lot of things are related to mental health. My name is a broad topic, and that's why I put up a survey on my Instagram story earlier today. So let's see who's gonna call. And I hope you pick up this call. I'm not sure if you pick it up. This one you press. Maybe you, I don't know. I'm gonna try my luck. First time, welcome to Abby's Life. Welcome, I appreciate you for joining for the first time. Can you talk where? Hi, Rebel Tomani. Thanks for joining. Welcome to Abby's Life. This happens every Tuesday, but due to certain reasons, I had to do it today. Beloved for me, thanks for joining as well. So I'm talking about mental health and its connection with suicide. I'm not yet to educate anyone, but I want us to just drop our comments. Do you think mental health is being overlooked by society? Especially in Africa, due to mental health is being overlooked. What's your opinion? And what do you think is the best way to help those who are depressed or who want to attempt suicide or who is attempting suicide? So, I think your network is bad. I'm not connecting at all. In a way, I'll try to call you back again. Let's see the request. Okay, Beloved for me has just sent a request. I'm gonna call Beloved for me right now. Oh, but you sent a request, Beloved for me. Why you decline? Okay, let's see what I can have. You can go back. to search for somewhere. If it could be send me a request again. Send me a request again. So I'll pick up your phone. Okay, I did get to know about mental health once I got to the US. It is real and it's been underrated in Africa. That's very cool of me. Thanks for dropping your comments. You won't even pick up my call. Thanks for dropping your comment. And that is the truth. In Africa, we don't believe there's anything called mental illness. I think what we regard as mental illness in Africa. Okay, so you're ready. Okay. Okay, thank you very much. I think what we call mental health and illness in Africa is like when somebody is like a lunatic, and that is not mental illness per se. Oh, it's not me that I have issues with mine. Good afternoon. I hope you can hear me. Oh, I can't hear you. Okay. And I can't hear you clearly. Oh, I can't hear you. Not at all. I don't know if it's the volume. I don't know. I can't hear you at all. I can't even hear you at all. Let me see. I don't know what happened now, but let me try to call you again. Let's see again. I don't know what happened with the next. I just could not hear you at all. Okay. Okay. Good afternoon. Thanks for joining my Instagram live.
Hear me now?
Yes, I can. Yeah, I can hear you now.
I just told you he actually exists. But I think in Nigeria, I say, we don't know about it. We weren't well educated, really. Because I didn't get to know about it until I got here, and then I got in contact with some people, and then this person will tell me, oh, don't talk to her, she's this, don't talk to her, she's that. You know, I've been is that. And I started viewing that, okay, this person in my country was going through this, and I didn't know. You know what I'm trying to say? When you're not educated about something, that is what it is. It actually exists. Depression is real. Mental illness is so real. You see some people, even, I don't know, high temper. When you get angry easily, it is from your brain. Yes. Everything here is attributed to your brain. Everything. When you do something, maybe good morning, honey, and then you get angry with it. It is from the brain. But we just look at it, meaning she's too off-tempered. No. All those things exist. If it doesn't exist, how do you think someone would pick up a knife and kill somebody she wants love or wants liked or the person she even gave birth to? How would you rape your own child? You know what I mean? I think he exists, and I think Africans, or maybe I'll say Nigeria, because that's the only African country I know so well. We need to start sensitizing people, educating them. let them know that some things that we attribute to her, Oshoni Ajani, I don't know if you remember, at times, you know, some things happen and we'll be like, oh, it's the devil's work. But no, I think it could be our own work. Let me tell you personally, I have to check myself on something, because there are some things I would do that I never knew until I got and they would take it to an English. Why are you this? What is the meaning of that? They'll be like, it's from the brain, a disease. Oh, no, no, I don't have this disease.
So, experience, yes.
No, I don't have it. But then, you know, I start checking myself and then start to relate it to every other person I've got in contact with, and they have exhibited that kind of attitude. You know what I'm trying to say? So it exists. People need to get aware that yelling at people unnecessarily might be out of frustration. And let me tell you, it could have affected the brain. So we attribute so many things to the devil, to witches and wizards. No, these things are illness that really needs medication. That's it. So that's all I'll say.
Thank you very much. I appreciate your contribution. God bless you. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Bye bye. Thank you.
Bye.
And yes, guys, she's actually right. Thanks for beloved Fumi, thanks for calling. This is the first time she's calling on my Instagram live, and I appreciate it. So I think people that will understand, people that actually live in Nigeria and left Nigeria to like a more civilized country, people that really understand the fact that in Africa we don't see the issue of mental illness under the carpet and say it doesn't exist. It's the devil that pushed him, it's the devil that did that. We have to pray and bind and cast, and the person is not a good Christian, the person didn't pray well. But no, it's just beyond that. It's not about the devil, but it's about the brain. Psychologically, how do you feel? When it comes to mental health, it's not about your well-being, like not just emotionally, but psychologically, you know, your total well-being, trying to understand. It's not about you having headache or having typhoid or malaria and say you are sick. There's also the mental illness as well. And she's absolutely right. It's not about which is a wizard. We have to sensitize everyone around us, Africa, wherever you are. Tell let people understand that, you know, just kind of so good, like, I'll give an example that some people, let me put it this way. Some people don't like that, maybe like from the Yoruba culture, they come over to this, so like the US or travel out. And suddenly, maybe the person, like, you know, a child gives a person something with his left hand, not the right hand. Like, oh, what is wrong with you? You are rude. You are this. You are that. That's because in Africa, it is believed that you show respect by giving someone a slap in with your right hand. I don't know if that's what I'm trying to say. So everything about sensitization. That things are, as for me, I would say in Africa we are not informed. In Africa we believe in all these traditions, culture, but life has advanced. The more life is advancing, the more we are having, you know, advanced illnesses, there are technological, you know, things. Yeah, there are a lot of things that, as good things are happening, bad things are happening. And we also carry inside ourselves and try to understand that it's not just about culture, it's not about the devil, it's not about witchcraft. But sometimes we have to use our common sense, sometimes we have to read about. So when it comes to mental health, talk to that person. When it comes to depression, speak to that person. Talk to that person, encouraging that person will actually go a long way. So let me see who's going to join. Okay, Femi Shine. Hi, thanks for joining. I want to also drop your contribution. That's what the time is. Okay, yeah, we still have time. So drop your comments or you can send me a request. I'm going to call you. It's about mental illness. I mean, just heard from Beloved Fumi. I want any other caller to also send a request now. And I will call you. So let me see if Femi Shine. Can I wait for a minute? Let me hear what Femi Shine has to say. Hi, Femi.
Hello.
What's up? Thanks for joining.
I was babysitting, so I just had the opportunity to, like, you know, just
okay. Jump in for a little bit. How is your baby?
Well, let me just, I don't know how to flip the screen. How do you flip the screen with this? Okay, it's right there, it's watching TV.
Oh, it's watching TV, that's nice.
that's the only time I can be free. Anyway, so okay. Now we're talking about mental health and its connection with suicide. So, now, I like speaking from a realistic point of view, and I like speaking based on what I grew up knowing. Do you understand? I am a Nigerian first. And as a result of that, I've grown up with a lot of cultural values, a lot of things that are already embedded in my system. So I like to speak from that point of view, you get me? So now, now that social media and the whole exposure there is, now we're shining the light on mental health in Nigeria, even though this has always been an underlying issue for decades. Do you understand? People are beginning to be confident to come out and actually acknowledge that it's a disease. Mental health is like, it's on the stage where we can classify it as a disease. Because it affects your overall being. It's like you have a headache now, you can't function 100%, right? That's how mental health is. So if there's any part of it that it affects you, your viral system shuts down. Now, I have had anxiety in the past. Do you understand? I grew up with mental issues. Yes. Anxiety is actually a mental health disease. Because you're always nervous. You're always worried about what you're going to do. You're worried about, it's kind of like affects your overall being in terms of self-esteem. You are always on the edge. Do you understand? So the way I was able to solve mine was, I looked at my self-esteem at a certain point in my life, like, okay, why am I not acknowledging my strength? Why am I pitching myself against other people and comparing my life? Do you understand? And I'm like, and I had a situation whereby someone that I really looked up to, that kind of like has set a standard for how I behave, how I see life, let me down in terms of morality. The person just let me down. Do you understand? And I look at the person's life like, wow, so you are actually not who you say you are. So that was my first fix in accepting that it's not everything don't look the way they seem. Do you understand? And I began to apply that to myself, that okay, I'm actually better than people that I'm pitching myself against. Why don't I sell my strength? Do you understand? Why don't I sell my strength? Why don't I even sell my weakness? Acknowledge my weakness and still sell that, like, you know, not think of it as a disadvantage. Do you understand? Because you can play every weakness to your advantage if you know what to do. Do you understand? So I was able to fix my anxiety. Over time, I built self-confidence. I will say my piece. Do you understand? I was able to now educate myself, because one of the things that fueled my anxiety was I lacked knowledge. I was smart, but I lacked knowledge. Do you understand? So if I go into a group now, I just want to be seen as that smart guy, but I lack knowledge to defend it. Do you understand? So what I did was I started getting into topics that I don't know about. I expanded my knowledge. So if I walk into a room and I want to say something, I know what I'm going to say. You will listen. It will make sense. So I was beginning to work on my anxiety in those angles. And then I realized that I'm not the perfect human being. Even as some days I'm very anxious, because as a man, the pressure is on me to, I know it's a cultural thing, but I've accepted it that pressure is on me as a man to provide, on me as a man to look responsible. There's so many things that's expected of me. So that fueled my anxiety as well, because I'm like, what if I fail in this stage? What if I fail in this stage? What if I fail in that? So that fueled my anxiety in some certain ways. But what I was able to do was gain knowledge, build myself a self-esteem to the point whereby if I don't know something, I'll acknowledge that I don't know it, and I'll allow myself to be taught. That's one thing. So, and what another thing that I was able to do was I surrounded myself with people who were better than I am and were ready to fuel my growth. Okay. That way, if they keep telling me, because people in life, we need someone that will reassure us. We need someone that will speak that confidence into our lives, even if sometimes we're on that downward spiral. Do you understand? Like, that's the person will tell you, don't worry, you're good. You're going to do this. You can do this. You can do that. Even if you fail, the person will still acknowledge your failure and say, you know what? You failed in this. This is how you improve. So I surrounded myself with people that were doing better than me, were on the same growth path as I was. And that kind of helped me relax and say, okay, I have this person. This person is telling me what to do, or this person can reassure me that I'm on the right path. I ask for advice. Do you understand? So then the whole anxiousness that comes from being a man, in the sense that can I provide for my family? Will I lose my job tomorrow? Is my future certain? All those things are variables that I cannot control to an extent. So I have to acknowledge I can't control some certain things, but I can work towards them. Because I will tell you, as much as mental health affects women, it affects men. I don't want to sound biased, but it affects men a lot more.
Yeah, I was going to say that. But when you said something about anxiety, I don't even know this guy on Instagram, Solomon Bucci. He said he's someone who's going through that anxiety as well.
Yeah.
And one time he traveled to Abuja, I was coming back on the flight, and he told the guy next to him, I said, you know what, I'm having this anxiety. Can you hold me while the plane goes up?
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, be a man. Now, what's wrong? So why can't you just be a man? And the guy was like, it's not about being a man. I'm a human being, this is what I feel. You understand? Yeah. So I think the pressure is on men. Uh-huh. And that's why most men go through that. Like, I don't know about statistics, but I feel men will be the ones coming to suicide more.
Men are the first gender that how would I put it? We don't get to 70 as much as women get beyond that. Do you understand? We break down very fast.
Yeah.
I live in Canada, so we have this generation they call the baby bloomers. That's the old people. They have a lot of them. And when I go around, I see women helping.
Leah, my name is Leah.
How are you?
Say hi to my viewers. Say hi. How are you doing?
These are the next generation that we have to help.
Yes, that's true.
We have to fix a lot of things for these people. We have to help them out. So, back to my train of thought. I've lost my train of thought. What was I saying? I've lost my train of thought.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's good. I can only focus on one thing at a time.
Thanks a lot, you love me. Overall, so, yeah, you talked about El Sharan. So, Tony said he also talked about his own mental health issue. That's a race key. I hope I'm pronouncing it well. He said, black people don't believe mental health is real. And that is true. Don't believe mental health is real. It's real. People commit suicide every day.
Do you know the most annoying part? If you attempt to commit suicide in Nigeria, you'll be arrested.
In Nigeria?
That is baffling. Yeah, if you attempt to commit suicide,
in Nigeria,
they are arrested.
Yeah, I think I've been
there. They will arrest you.
Instead of taking to psychology.
That is the most appalling thing that I've ever read. Someone is attempting to get out of a frustrated situation. You arrest the person and put the person into a deep
situation. Yes.
You understand? So, you know, it's appalling. We don't have a system that helps. You understand? I've seen a therapist before. I went for something else. I went for counseling for something totally unrelated. And when there were two, actually in Nigeria, before I visited Nigeria, so I had to see them. They opened a can of worms in my life. Do you understand? Like, they opened a file. Mm-hmm. My life, and they were able to trace the issues I was going through to that particular event. I sat down and I'm an African so when you sit in front of a therapist, you're like, these people just want to collect your money. They just want to collect your money and all of that. But the first time I sat down with the therapist, I realized that a lot of the things my character, my behavior, fueled by events that I've experienced when I was very young. And one of them, that I'm just going to put this out, one of the things that was open was I have been a very promiscuous person in my 20s. Do you understand?
Yeah.
I loved having sex. I loved flirting around. So one thing she opened was she traced it back to my childhood, and I was surrounded with a lot of girls. I was surrounded with maids that were just molesting us left and right, center. We just did everything. So I thought it was normal to chase women and sleep with them and overcome, like, surprise them and move on. It was, to me, it was fueling my ego. So instead, you are going to a relationship now and you're having all these issues. If you don't fix those things, if you don't acknowledge that you have a problem, because the first step she said is you have to acknowledge that you have a problem. I said, I could not, at this point, I could not now get, I'm like, yes, I have a problem, because they've opened everything. Yeah. I said, you need to fix this thing, otherwise you're going to continue this trend. And a trend is something you do. Sorry, a pattern is something you do over and over again. Yeah. So you know, she said, in this relationship, did you cheat? I said, yes. She decided the next one, did you cheat? I said, yes. She was, so it was a pattern. I said, you see that? You're going to continue doing this if you don't go fix it. You understand? So a lot of people don't acknowledge these things as issues. So when she sat down and said, Femi, you are promiscuous because of these things. You see it as normal. You don't see women in the light like this.
Like, yeah.
So you need to fix that so you can begin to see women in this light. That way you can have a sustainable relationship. Do you understand?
Yeah, I think we need psychologists in Africa. We need a lot of them.
There are very good psychologists, general hospital in Lagos. A lot of them. A lot of
people visit them. People go there to talk to the psychologist.
That's the thing. There's a stigma attached to visiting. Like, exactly. We are all this manly.
No.
Actually, very good. Some of the psychologists that are in general hospital, they actually own big practices where they make more money compared to the government, because nobody visits them in the general hospital. So they have private counseling, therapy sessions and all of that. Do you understand? So we need, one going into a relationship, going into anything, anything you're going through in life, you need to see someone to talk to, an expert in that case, because life that we are now is very, very overwhelming. I will not lie to you, our generation is overwhelmed. We are facing a lot more. Our generation is facing challenges that is now being brought to the surface. Do you understand? From depression to anxiety to low self-esteem, name it. Our generation, now that even with social media, it is more pronounced. I know someone that would not wear the same outfit to take pictures for Instagram. Never. This is the person that would never do it.
No.
They will have to go and look for a new clothes to take a picture and upload. Look at that. Look at the self-esteem there. See that issue now? So that one, that's self-esteem is already an issue there. So anxiety, self-esteem, depression, there's a whole lot. She gave me a whole lot of list of things that people go through. There's this word.
Schizophrenia.
Yes.
That's I heard about that. That's what they said. You hear voices in your head.
You would not hear voices. You will see.
In Africa, they would say it's witchcraft.
You will see. You don't only hear. You will see. There's a
you also thing see,
that
yeah.
Russell Crowe did. Beautiful Minds. And if you can watch that movie, okay. I think he won the Nobel Prize for some science related thing. So this guy, smart guy, everything. We were suffering from schizophrenia, and he was seeing people, and he was talking to people. He was having intelligent conversations with people that other people did not, can't see. And I'm like, do you know how many people in Nigeria are going through this?
I'm telling you.
Do you know how many people are going through this, like, have conversations with themselves, and they've built their own reality? That nothing you can see. And, do you understand?
Yes.
This our mind is programmable. Do you understand? Your mind can be programmed. Let me just let you understand that you can be programmed even through digital media to go and do things that you not normally do on a good day.
Yes.
Now let's look at all those suicide bombers. They've been programmed to believe certain things. Do you understand? So our brain can be programmed, and the moment our brain accept an ideology, it's very hard to reset, which is what we're facing now with we trying to fix misogyny and trying to bring women into positions of power and everything.
Yeah.
We men have been programmed to not see women as equals. That's the program. So now we're trying to reset the program, which is what everybody's saying now, feminism and everything. I'm all for that. I guess women need to come to this table and sit with us, and we need to fix all this issue. Do you understand? But we've been programmed, you know, in that way. So back to what I'm saying about mental health, we need to remove that stigma. We need to talk to each other. We need to talk to each other and have very, very sincere conversations about how we feel. We should stop suppressing and all of that. We need to have sincere conversations. So I'm going to end this with anybody that is listening, don't talk all the time to people that are trying to talk to you. Listen to them. Actually sit down and listen, because everybody's crying for help. But just because we're not listening, we can't hear. Help. Do you understand? If someone is saying, I don't feel good today, the moment someone says, I don't feel good today, and you ask them, do you have headache? Do you have this? They say, no. Have a smart conversation. Don't say, oh, I feel the same way too. No, you don't feel the same way too. Don't say, oh, it's like to feel like that someday. No, absolutely not. You don't feel the same way too. Ask them how they feel. Walk through it. Do you understand? And when talk to them. And when you suggest help, don't suggest they should go for that help alone, because they will not have the confidence to go. Just hold your hands and walk with them. Go for those sessions with them, because they need that support. If you say go, I mean, me, if that is why I'm buying Panadol for chemists, I'm not going anywhere. I'm just trying to go. I need someone to hold my hand, you know, hold that person's and walk with them. Let them understand. Do you understand? We need to drop our character and just open up and be vulnerable. If you need to cry, cry. Do you understand? Hold it. Sit and listen to, why is this person crying? Touch base with them. Do you understand? Understanding is all we need. And a little bit of love.
And Femi, someone is asking, what do you tell them, Femi?
In what relation, like, what is she asking about? What?
I think maybe, for those when you say you talk to people that want that, you think needs your help, now what do you tell them to kind of, you know, take them out of that mood?
See, you can't take someone out of a mood. The only thing you can do is just give them temporary relief. You can make them laugh, make them smile at the time they're feeling down. But you're just giving a short-term solution to a long-term problem. That's why I said, when you suggest a therapist or a counselor with them, fix a date to go with them to go and see those people. Don't just say, oh, I made her laugh. You think she's good? No. There's an underlying issue that needs to be fixed. Do you understand? Listen to them. So I know another thing that I would suggest is, let's reach out to all these churches. The highest place Nigerians go to are churches. Let's find a way to have conversations where we can now put counselors, mental therapists in the church. Because
counselors, not that will go and say your secrets out. That's not problem. So
if someone is dying of malaria, I can still drag their nyash to church. That's how important church is to us. Someone is dying of fever, I will still drag him myself to the mosque. Because they still believe. So
yeah, I know someone that has died because they did not go to the hospital. Their church believes that as a Christian you don't go to the hospital. Imagine such stupidity.
So let's have a this. As much as we have a choir stand, as much as we have other people that let's have at the small office in our churches where people can come for not relationship and religious counseling, mental health counseling. Do you understand? Let's create that safe space for them to be able to come and talk. And when you come in there, don't talk about Christ Jesus. Don't talk about anything. Just talk about their mental health. Don't ask them to go and pray. Don't ask them to go and fast. Talk about their mental health and how you can offer help or refer them to other places where they can get help. Do you understand? So, yeah, I'm going to close on that note. That let's listen.
Yeah, because even my life ends in 2 minutes.
Okay. Now, feel free to educate people as much as you can from what I've said. And, you know, I hope we've all learned something. And thanks for giving me an opportunity to be on your platform once again.
Thanks for giving your suggestion and your contribution. I appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
You're always welcome. Bye.
Okay, guys. Thank you for today. There are a lot of comments here that I can't talk about. Irezi Franca said, before one seek for help, he or she will have to accept that they have a problem. In Africa, most of us don't believe that, and that is the truth. We don't want to accept that we are depressed. We don't want to accept that we are going through something. We don't want to feel like we are Superman or Superwoman, mighty gun. We can handle everything, and that's a lie. We all need someone to talk to. We need a shoulder to cry on whenever we are going through situations. So, guys, mental illness is real. Suicide is real. Everything cannot be solved by prayers or by reading the Bible or all of that. You need to see a psychologist. You need to speak to someone. You need to be there for someone. Do not judge people who are depressed. Do not consider them as, you know, mentally weak because they're not mentally weak. Don't say they are violent because they're not violent. They're not going through a particular thing. And sometimes in that particular person's statement or in that, whatever you call that long statement of rubbish, there is something you can actually pick up. So this is what this person is going through. Some people are angry, and you feel this person is just rude, the person is just arrogant. But it's beyond that. try to talk to the person. So guys, thanks for joining, and hope to see you next week. It's going to be Tuesday next week by, as we say, 26 seconds remain. Okay, so see you next week. If you have not subscribed to my channel, it's called Abby's Corner. So go to my page and click on the link there, subscribe to my channel. And I do this every Tuesday, but for some reason I didn't just I lost it.